This is a University of Sheffield Health Service screencast. Welcome to the screencast on the contraceptive injection. We'll cover what it is, how it works, how effective it is, its advantages and its disadvantages. The contraceptive injection is a member of a group called the long-acting reversible contraceptives, so we'll first cover what these are. There are four different types of long-acting reversible contraceptives. The first is a copper intrauterine device called IUD, or copper coil. Then there is the intrauterine system, or IUS. Thirdly, there are contraceptive injections. And lastly, there is the contraceptive implant. LARCs are suited for women who want contraception without having to remember to take it daily or at the time of intercourse. Their effects are also reversible, so there's no long-term effect on your fertility. It has been found that women who use LARCs have less unwanted pregnancies than those who use the pill, because the pill is only 99% effective if it's used perfectly. LARCs are particularly suited to those women who have a body mass index, or BMI, over 30, have diabetes or migraines with or without aura, and those who can't take estrogen-containing contraceptives. It should be remembered that LARCs do not provide protection against sexually transmitted infections, so use a condom in addition if you think you are at risk. The contraceptive injection is an injection of progesterone that's given every 8 to 12 weeks. It works by preventing ovulation, which is the release of the eggs from the ovaries. Contraceptive injections are very effective. Over 2 years of use, the pregnancy rate is less than 4 in 1,000. The advantages of using the contraceptive injection is that it's not affected by antibiotics or certain other medications, such as those that induce liver enzymes. They are also safe to use when breastfeeding. The disadvantages of contraceptive injections are as follows. Up to 50% of women stop using this method within the first year due to changes in their bleeding pattern, including infrequent or prolonged bleeding. However, by 12 months usage, most women stop having periods. There can be a delay in return to fertility up to 1 year after discontinuation of contraceptive injections, but there is no reduction in overall fertility thereafter. A potential side effect is weight gain. There is no association with mood change, loss of libido, or headaches. It's also linked to a small reduction in the density of bone minerals, such as calcium. This is usually recovered after stopping the injections, and there is no evidence to suggest that this poses an increased risk of fractures, but it's worth discussing this with your doctor every 2 years when using this method. For further information and to view the reference material we've used, please note the following. You can view these only if you've enabled the annotations function. This is the end of the screencast on the contraceptive injection.